There's been a lot of discussion about the 2018 15-inch MacBook Pro, particularly the i9 configuration, because of some potential thermal issues. Now, in my original video about this whole topic, I noticed that the 2018 model, the i9, was somehow slower for my workflow than the 2017 model, the i7 3.1 GHz. So the fastest one from last year was a little bit faster than the fastest one from this year, which doesn't make sense, right? That should never be the case with any tech product. And I ran those tests over and over and over again, before I published the video, after I published the video, with new versions of Premiere, new versions of Intel's monitoring program, and I got the same kind of result. The new MacBook was slower than the old MacBook because of some thermal issue. Now, in this whole thing, Apple reached out to me pretty early on, tried to figure out what it was that was causing this. So I worked with them, sent them like all the information I had about my camera, what settings I was using, and today they put out a new update, 10.13.6, that addresses the thermal issues in the new MacBook Pros. And I asked them if it was related to the VRM stuff that we've seen pop up on Reddit, and they say it isn't, but the short of it is that they fixed the issues I was seeing in my workflow. So, my videos now render at significantly better speeds, even better than using a freezer before the patch. Instead of being slower than the 2017 MacBook Pro, the new i9 is now like 30, maybe 35% faster than the older 2017 model, which makes sense and is quite frankly relieving, because the new one should always be faster than the old one. So, my stance on the i9 MacBook Pro right now, I'm obviously happy that it performs better than it did before, and it's a better product. It's a more compelling purchase than it was a week ago, because now if you're really looking for something that's high end in the portable Apple category, you now have an option that makes sense for everybody, provided that you want to spend that kind of money. That being said, it still does not hit the clock speed that it could potentially hit, but I'm okay with that. So this is why. In front of me are seven laptops, but six core i9 laptops. These are the thick boys, these are the not so thick boys. So these are like gaming laptops. They're big, they're thick, and they're ugly in comparison to something like this, but they're designed to cool the chip really well. They can hit like 4.5, maybe 5 GHz and maintain that clock speed comfortably. They're loud, but they do it really well. These use the same chip, but they can't hit that. They're floating around closer to base clock, which is like 2.9 gigahertz. The XPS 15 and the ZenBook Pro are a little bit thicker, a little bit bigger than the MacBook, but they have slightly better performance. The MacBook has one big advantage. It's really quiet. It's thin and light like the other two, but it's quieter than the rest, and the fans don't come on very often. It's actually one of the reasons why I enjoy using MacBook Pros, because they're quiet and they're just unobtrusive in the office. So at this point, I would say I'm content. I feel like the i9 MacBook Pro is performing at least the way that a 6-core MacBook should perform. You're never gonna get performance like this. You're also not even gonna get performance like the XPS 15 or the ZenBook Pro, because those are bigger devices, but it is what it is. Now, my only criticism at this point is that I wish Apple had engineered a better thermal solution, like hardware-wise, for the i9. It wouldn't have made financial sense, because not a lot of people are buying the i9. It's very costly and time consuming to engineer something like this, but for the i9 owners, it could have made a big difference, and I think that the user base would have been really happy with it. But we have at least a usable solution for now. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thumbs if you liked it, subs if you loved it. See you guys next time.